I know. Long time, no thrift. Hola, what is up, you guys? My name is Anna. I am a Latina content creator. Si tú también eres Latina o Latino, déjame saber en los comentarios de dónde me estás viendo. Today, I have... Obviously, as you can tell, we're finally doing a thrift haul. It's been a hot minute since I have gone thrifting. I notice I do thrifting when I have a lot of downtime. When I don't, I just don't bother. I've been busy, I've been traveling, just, you know, living my life. I recently got rid of about 80% of the clothes I own. I sold a lot of them on my stories. I took some of them to Goodwill and I sold some at a Buffalo Exchange. And while I was there, just browsed around the store and I found a couple things that are very niche for a transitional fashion wardrobe, or basically what we like to call LA winter, even though I'm not in LA anymore. I'm in Nashville and we get true winter. I'm rambling too much. You can literally skip to the haul. I'm gonna leave it right here. I just love to ramble, but I also like to respect y'all's time. So anyways, since I moved to Nashville, I never really had the four seasons. Spring, summer, fall, winter. I lived in LA, and before LA, I lived in Mexico, so it was basically summer all year long. I ended up only getting a couple key pieces because I clean my closet massively. I'm just trying to be more conscious about the clothes that I'm actually going to wear. When I pick an item, I have to at least picture 2 to 3 outfits with that one piece. If I can only picture myself wearing it one specific way, then it's not an item worth being in my closet, which is why I thought it would be a great idea to make this video, show you my little teaser fall thrift haul, but also show you how I would style each items more than one way. So also take this as fashion inspo for this transitional weather that we're currently going through right now. But anyways, longest intro ever. If you decided not to skip to the actual haul, thank you so much for listening to my words. Let's start with the haul and the styling. It cannot be a thrift haul without a graphic shirt in the back. You guys, the back is where the party is at. If you have watched any of my thrift videos, you know I am a fanatic of graphic shirts. I feel like 80% of what I wear is truly graphic shirts. Literally wearing one right now. Unless I'm dressing nice to something, most likely you're gonna find me wearing a graphic tee. This one I really liked because I truly have nothing like it. And this is something that I've been asking also myself lately when I buy for things. I'm like, do I have something already similar? It says 23rd annual Top Gun 208 Lake of the Ozarks shootout. I don't know, I feel like the graphic is pretty cool. This is what the graphic in the front looks like. I have a bunch of ideas of how I would like to style this one, so let's style this shirt. Okay, so here's the first outfit idea for the t-shirt. I know what you're thinking, Anna, this is literally biker shorts and a t-shirt. Because we're in transitional weather, you can wear Doc Martens and not be sweating your feet off. So this is an outfit I would wear just to go out and about. And I don't know, maybe like you can throw furs to make it a little bit more elevated, a little bit more casual. You guys know I'm literally all about mixing high and low. I mean, this is as low as one can get, and this is as high as one can get. Isn't this outfit so stunning? And like, you don't have to have a YSL purse. You guys already know my other favorite one is this one from Coach, which is the one that I had for the longest time before I decided to pull the trigger and buy the YSL one. Going to work at a coffee shop, trying to be comfy, grocery store, I don't know, whatever casual date you want to think of. This is one way that I would style this t-shirt. The next t-shirt outfit idea, also something very casual. You know, it's a t-shirt. Naturally, outfits are gonna gravitate towards that kind of style. I have been seeing a bunch of girls on Instagram wear oversized graphic shirts, some loose pants, and then a very tomboy sneaker. I don't know how to call it, just something very sporty. Obviously, if that's not your vibe, you can just tuck it in like this. And the way I would style it, probably with this cutie little purse, just like this. Again, another cute but casual outfit that is not very, she's cool, she's edgy, trendy. You can also throw in like a black hat. This really ties in the whole outfit that matches the shoes, and you're keeping it casual. Maybe if you didn't do your hair that day, just definitely like a more tomboy vibe. So this is another way that I would style it. And then last but not least, for this t-shirt outfit idea, I figured it'd be something a little bit more dressy just in case the others were too casual for you. This is a really cute outfit. Go out for dinner, I don't know, maybe like a first date. I haven't been on a first date literally in 7 years since I started dating Chase. We want to look dressed up, but also the t-shirt immediately makes it look super laid back. The pointy boots, cute little nighttime purse. I was actually going to pair this outfit with my white platform Converse, but again, I figured you'd be a little bit more of a dressy option. But if you're trying to keep it casual, maybe during the date, I would definitely swap the boots for the platform Converse. I feel like this is very underrated to style graphic shirts. It's to wear dressy, flowy pants with them. These are there's just like your regular trouser, slack pants. There's a ton of them everywhere in every single store. Never underestimate the power of a formal flowy pant with a graphic shirt. The next item that I have to show you is this dress. And I know you're looking at it, you're like, Anna, this is summer. What do you mean transitional? Just wait for it. Because actually, transitional slash fall weather, when it's not too cold, is one of my favorite seasons to wear dresses like this. And I, if I'm being completely honest, wouldn't necessarily feel 100% confident wearing literally just this in the summer. I don't know, just something about me likes to be covered a little bit more. Still working on that. You know, we're doing some inner body confidence work. But for now, I'm going to show you how I would style this one for transitional weathers. Just because it's getting a little bit more chilly doesn't mean you cannot be playful with your outfits. Maybe like a little sexy date night. For some reason, nothing is more fall than animal print. It might not be the case for you, but so let me show you how I would style this one.
In my opinion, the best way to dress these type of sexy dresses for the colder months is to throw not just a jacket on top or a sweater, but an oversized jacket, because if you think about it, it's super contrasting how fitted this dress is versus the oversized, like, slouchy looking. I just live for these moments where you have the perfect balance of feminine and masculine in your outfits. I decided to pair it with these boots from Urban Outfitters. They're super old. These are from last fall. I know every time I wear them, I get asked a ton about them, but they don't make them anymore. Cute little black purse will be fine. You already have so much going on, so why not throw on like a little dainty purse? This can literally be equally as great for day or nighttime. It's also casual, but it's cool. So you're gonna at the restaurant, then you take the jacket off and you're like, oh, I bet you didn't expect this, you know? This is one way to style this dress. Following that same oversized jacket rule, kind of, that I basically made up literally 5 minutes ago, this is one of my favorite jackets. It is an oversized leather jacket. It hits lower than normal jackets. It's also long in the sleeves. Kind of looks like you're wearing your boyfriend's jacket. Like the boyfriend jean, but leather jacket version. Paired with something as feminine and dainty as this dress, brings a little bit more of that edge. For this outfit, I decided to dress it down with some sneakers. I feel like just leather and zebra can be a little bit out there. Fine balance between tacky and trendy. Making sure that we have a very contemporary trendy piece like plaid for Converse. It would be a great way to make sure we get the right vibes with this look. And as far as my purse, I would probably throw something like this just to bring more of that girly trendy element. This is my last styling option for this dress.
The next item that I got is a very classic fall piece. It is a sweater vest. I specifically wanted a sweater vest that can be worn on its own as an actual t-shirt. Figured this is a piece that will look so stunning with a bunch of jewel, like the necklace I'm wearing, layered and stuff. But anyways, oh wait, this is made in Mexico. Oh my goodness, we love to see. Okay, so this is made in Mexico, just like me. Let's go into the styling part for this one.
Oh my god, this outfit is sending me. Your grandpa, but way, way cooler than that. Oh my gosh, I love this. It's exactly how I picture. Let me show you a little bit more up close.
This is what I meant when I say I picture this with a bunch of layer stuff.
I feel like for me personally, what looks the coolest is have it tucked in here and kind of let it fall loose on the side. Pretty warm and cozy, which is perfect for fall. I really can't decide which purse will look better. I feel like this is a little too obvious, a little too much black. This makes a little bit more edgy, so let's go for this one.
Oh my goodness, are you kidding me? You guys, this outfit is so pretty. I cannot wait to actually wear this. Oh my gosh, I am so glad I got this vest.
The only way I can think of styling this one up or switching things is shoes. You can throw in boots. You can throw in white sneakers, Converse. You can throw on one of these jackets and keep myself warm and cozy. One thing I did make sure when I was trying it on is that the V-neck, because in some vests, it goes like pretty deep down. So I don't know if you want to wear that as a shirt. The higher the neck, the more it would resemble a t-shirt. But this is such a cool way to switch it up a little bit. Like, it's super simple. It's literally jeans, sneakers, and a top. Just having something unexpected like a vest instead of a t-shirt is what makes your outfits look super, super stylish. So I am obsessed with this one.
And the last item I have to show you, I told you this is kind of a small teaser haul. I really wasn't kidding when I say that. But I also want to encourage you to, when you go shopping or thrifting, be conscious of the things that you get and make sure you're getting items that truly speak to you. I know I'm talking from experience because I still do. I'm still working on it. I have a terrible shopping habit. Having this recent closet clean out, I literally found myself getting rid of 80% of my clothes. It made me realize there's so many things that I just buy when I'm not being conscious about it. But this dress, oh my goodness, I know it looks a little bit basic just looking at it, but just wait for it. I already have a few outfit ideas for this one. I mean, obviously worn as is could be cool, but let's see how we can spice this one up and make our outfits look a lot cooler.
I feel like you can never go wrong with sneakers when it comes to a girly dress like this one. When I'm styling dresses that are too feminine like this one for my personal style, what I like to do is immediately put something that would take a little bit of the girliness down. Again, I'm all about balancing that perfect feminine but opposite of feminine at the same time, if that even makes sense. Are we even surprised at this point? I cannot stop wearing this purse ever. I would also throw some sunglasses, a little bit more elevated. In this case, the outfit is all about the accessories. This is how I would style these type of dresses. If I was to wear this one to dress it up, this is exactly how I would wear it. Throwing in the leather jacket immediately makes any dress transitional acceptable. You're still getting away with wearing sandals just to keep it a little bit more summery. Also, transitional fashion is the one time they can get away with wearing a leather jacket in an open toe shoe. I'll probably do this one, something black and simple to keep everything more monochromatic. This is how I would style this one for fall. I wanted to include a little bit of a more experimental type of outfit. It's also been a personal challenge to find ways to style this vest. I got it earlier in the spring, and I'm not gonna lie, I struggle often with how to style it. I found the season for it. It's transitional season. Just throw this on top of any dresses. It can also be long sleeve dresses. You know, it's all about the layers. We're finally able to wear them. Whenever I don't know what purse will go with my outfit, I usually grab this one. Definitely more of a statement outfit. If you don't mind taking risks or being a little bit more bold, this is a really cool way to wear a dress. I like that it's very, very funky, yet it's like a super cool dress. It's either gonna be a love-hate situation, and for me, definitely a love. If it's a hate, listen, I completely understand. I just wanted to throw in one more last outfit option for you.
That is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoy this little teaser fall thrift haul. I am so excited to dive full into the next season's fall winter. It's my favorite as far as fashion. Let me know in the comments which one was your favorite piece, and also let me know which outfit you are going to be recreating. Would love to see. That being said, thank you so much for watching. Muchas gracias por ver este video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.